Good morning, I'm Andres Kim, and here are your headlines for May 11, 2011. There are officially 2 days left until all APs are over. Hope everyone finishes strong with the remaining APs. The upcoming Sunday, the 15th, is the official Teachers Day for Korea. Take the time to write a thank you letter for your favorite educator. Next Friday, the 20th, is a curriculum day. Students can enjoy a day of rest and relaxation. That very Friday is also the 2011 prom, Moon River, happening in Fradia. Tickets will go on sale soon.
Welcome to another PTV segment. It's the second week of May, and we hope everyone had a pleasant Children's Day last Thursday. I'm Megan Song.
And I'm Andres Kim. Congratulations, sophomores, juniors, and seniors. There are only 2 days left till AP exams are over.
The past week and a half have been stressful for many, but the end is near. Reporters Hannah Kim and Ji-hee Roo give us tips on how to be successful in the remaining AP tests.
AP. Two simple letters, but a whole lot of stress behind it. Starting from Monday of last week, KIS students took advanced placement tests ranging from AP Literature to AP Calculus BC. During these testing hours, students gave their best to get that golden five. But above all, this year's AP season served as an opportunity for students to celebrate their accomplishments in a college-level course. With two more days of AP to go, PTV takes you to explore some stress relief tips and further reflection about this week's AP season.
I took AP Psych, AP Calculus BC, and AP Lit.
I took Calc, Chem, US, and English.
So what AP are you guys taking this year?
Bio.
I just play sports and try to listen to music, calm myself.
I watch TV and sleep and eat, and play.
Sleep and a lot of water and a good breakfast.
Sleep, have lots of fun, do something fun, a reward.
He doesn't get stressed.
I don't really get stressed because I don't really.
We don't get stressed. We're seniors.
Don't grab.
I probably study before and more because I started studying for AP test starting yesterday. So yeah, I'm cramming so much right now.
Relax. It's gonna be fine. You don't die. You don't die even if you get a one.
Just relax. Go take a nap for like an hour or two and study again.
Almost there for those who are taking AP Econ and AP World History. For sophomores and juniors, you have another year to look forward to before the next AP season. Seniors, well, we're done. Until now, this is Hannah Kim and Ji-hee Roo from PTV.
We all know that KIS High School mascot is Filbert, and that our school colors are blue and white.
So how well do the seniors know about the university they will be attending next year? Reporters Rachel Moon and Paul Byun asked the seniors.
With only a month left for graduation, PTV was curious of the level of preparation that the class of 2011 had for their following academic year. We decided to give them a little trivia to see who would spend their first weeks breezing through the campus or simply lost among the crowds.
What year was the school founded?
It was founded in the year of 1979, May 26th at 7 p.m.
My school? When Andrew Carnegie said that
$4,600,022.
Oh! Oh wait! $42,000! I think got a Blue Jays!
Fighting Irish.
Oh yeah, I knew that.
Blues. I know.
Wow. Ignored.
So well.
More than 200.
I don't even know the partial name. I'm not even kidding. Like, how am I supposed to know the full name? It's just a game. How come I've never won? I guess maybe it's possible. 2,500.
5 million.
Yay!
As unprepared as a senior class may seem to be, they have spent years growing up to become great individuals. Next time you see them, give them a pat on the back and congratulate them on their hard work. This is Rachel Moon and Paul Byun, PTV.
What's the area that marked the rebirth of humanism and the revival of cultural achievements? The area that rediscovered ancient Greek ideals.
The Renaissance period. I hear middle school held a unique affair on Renaissance. Reporter Jane Wu, tell us more.
Who was King John? What kind of food did the people of the 15th and 16th centuries eat? What kind of music did they listen to? Welcome to the first annual KIS Renaissance Fair, where these questions and many more can be answered. The 7th graders of KIS have worked diligently into making these projects and presentations to educate their classmates about this monumental moment in history.
On May 3rd, the KIS Renaissance Festival was hosted by the 7th grade class in the G building of KIS. There, the students were able to show off their projects and knowledge about their specific area of the Renaissance.
King John is one of the most controversial kings of England. He's a very bad king.
This is his face.
Our project is mainly about Shakespeare and talks about Shakespeare's life.
The festival was organized by Mrs. LaRue, also known as the Queen.
They really do enjoy it because they can use all their technical skills and all their artistic skills and their creative skills, and it's a great deal of fun because they get to be the teachers rather than just the students.
Students rush excitedly to see what this exhibition is all about.
Did you learn anything new from this fair?
I was even able to enjoy some Renaissance-style foods and grade other projects on their quality.
Can you show us how that castle works again?
The festival was a flurry of art, creativity, and knowledge that teachers and students alike could enjoy.
I have thoroughly enjoyed my time at this fair, and the whole school recognizes the hard work that the 7th graders have put into this event. We hope to see many more fairs and festivals in the future, so until then, back to you, PTV.
36 days left to the last day of school.
24 days left to June SATs.
23 days left till graduation.
9 days left till prom.
7 days left to the next PTV episode. Until then, enjoy the rest of your day. And
keep flying, Phoenix!
Are you gonna edit it?
Yeah.
Did I just talk about it?
Yeah.
Well, when I was little, well, not really little, when I was in the States, we had like this tree next to our house, and we called it a leaning tree, and then it was like that. So for my birthday, me and my friends, like, we climbed the tree and we took pictures and we had barbecue parties in front of it.
One of my fondest memories growing up was really just kind of playing baseball in the summers and going to a lot of Brewers games. I remember going to my first one with my dad, and it was kind of cool because it was a school night, so we got, you know, stay out really late.
The very first graduation picture I've ever taken, really special because this was the first and last graduation picture for such a long time.
Do I want to go back to being a kid?
I do miss my childhood. Being irresponsible for my actions and being really like silly and loud.
You know, not having as many responsibilities or different responsibilities. I mean, I remember growing up, like, you know, when you're 7 or 8 and someone won't, like, your friend won't talk to you, and, you know, that's like the worst deal. And I'm like, shoot, if that was like the least of my problems, you know, today, that'd be, I'd be doing all right. I enjoyed that period of my life a lot, but, you know, for a couple days, you know, it might be kind of fun. So.
I still am a child. I can't.
You're probably wondering how I, Douglas Lee, the bottom of the social totem pole at my high school, was able to take Olivia Kim, the most popular, prettiest girl in town, to my senior prom. My few friends told me that I wouldn't even get the words, "Will you go to prom with me?" out of my mouth before I had a nervous breakdown. So, one day by chance, I happened to find out what her favorite thing in the whole wide world was. It was my dog, Charlie. As stupid as I'd looked being dragged by my dog to her, Charlie had happened to be the best conversation starter I had. And I used him to tell her she was my favorite in the whole wide world. It was a little different than the traditional question, but I knew this method was better than using my nervous, squeaky voice. I'm not sure what would have happened if I had listened to all my friends, but I knew that day, I was proud I listened to myself.